The future of building innovative takt planning techniques. In this video, I'm going to show you some really cool things that you can just start to do to create flow and create a rhythm on your project. So would you like to know what takt is really all about? What exercises you can do to begin your lean journey? And then how you can expand it to create an entire plan? If you do, you've come to the right video. Stay with us. Okay, so I'm super stoked to be on the flip charts with us because I'm going to give you some really neat things, some frameworks that you can use to just go ahead and start this tomorrow if you want. But I want you to know the word takt is the German word for rhythm or baton. It symbolizes a rhythm or being on a beat, right? And that's important because the general contractor on a site has got to, especially since all of our trades are separate, right? They're separate companies, get everybody on a rhythm. Flow comes from everybody going the same speed, the same distance apart on a takt time. And so that's key. So when we talk about takt planning, we're talking about production planning, okay? So that's really at the basis. So when you do takt planning, you've got a couple of key things. You've got a visual schedule, you've got a really nice optimized sequence, you've got good trade flow for the trades, you've leveled your work, and you have a framework where mathematically we can analyze what the fastest pace is, and we can analyze things like cycle time, work in process, your overall throughput, your overall duration, and a number of other things. So takt at its basis, when you hear that word, I want you to think flow. I want you to think flow production or flow scheduling. So here are just some key concepts. I'm not going to take you through the overall system. I'm just going to give you some key concepts that you can use right away when you are implementing on your project site. So I want you to know a couple of different things. When you flow, what you'll want to do is really analyze, do you have your trades leveled? So there's a really neat activity. If you're in a time by location format and you say, hey, this is zone 1, 2, and 3, and you break up, and let's actually just say that this is a 40,000 square foot floor, and these are your three zones, okay? If you say, hey, what is the sequence for this floor over here? You might say, okay, trade partner number 1 takes that long, trade partner number 2 takes that long, trade partner 3 takes that long. Well, this horizontal flow, you might think, oh yeah, these are fine, that's a lot of flow. No. Because this is gonna come down, knowing that you only have one resource, right? Gonna come down here, and this one, knowing that you only have one resource, is gonna look like this, and then you're gonna see this break. And then if you did this again, this is what it would look like, and I'll actually have to go in reverse on the paper here, right? And then there, because that's what it's going to look like. So you notice that there's a problem. The line of balance or the speed at which this first trade is going is slower than this one right here. So we do not have leveled trades. And so we have a problem. And if you took this and you could add another or buy out another trained crew, you can increase their capacity, you could do a lot of different things. But if you said, hey, this is an 8-person crew, and I'm going to break that up and make them work in, or ask them to work in succession, then it would literally look like this. You would have crew number 1, the half of this crew, the half of this crew, and then this. And then when you came down here to the second one, it would literally look like this, and it would finish fairly well on time. And I'll draw this with a different marker. So you're going this first crew down to the second crew down to the third crew, all good. The same with all of the rest of them, down here to this crew, this one down here to this crew, this one down here to this crew. So the end date here was a lot shorter, and we pulled it in simply by leveling the trades. So that's number 1. If you want to have flow, you have got to level your trades. So when you're like, hey, Jay Money, I've maybe heard this from you before, hold on a minute. You can do this exercise with civil crews, with multifamily crews, with general commercial construction, with industrial. Basically, you take your area and you draw this out and you simulate what your different speeds are, and you can see that you'll have different end dates. So you can split your crews, you can add additional crews, you can improve the process steps, but this is the way that you see your bottlenecks. Okay. Now, there may also be a bottleneck when it comes to your zones. Typically, we separate our zones into equal square feet or square meters. But let's say that the work here was really, really dense here in the middle. And so when you come, when the crew comes into this zone, they experience this much work, right? Okay. And then they go to the next zone, they experience a lot of work. Okay. And then they go to the third one and they experience a little bit of work. The zones are not leveled, so you're going to have trouble. So what's going to happen here, and I hope this is landing, is that you won't have the beautiful cascade. You would actually see that each of these activities are getting longer just within this one zone, and that you have a problem. So what you need to do is, instead of having equal area or square foot or square meter zones, you need to adjust the zone to where the first zone right here has a similar density to the second and a similar density to the third, right? Adjust these, okay, to where your work in each zone actually looks something like this, and it's leveled and it's not in variation, okay? So that's the second thing that you can do. You can not only in the beginning see the problem possibly with your actual trades because you have a bottleneck in your trade. You can also see, hey, do I have a bottleneck in my zone? The last thing that I want to say from a flow standpoint is that you can really, really do well when you're optimizing your schedules by looking at how many zones you have. So if you have zones 1 and 2, and let's just take this for an example, and you have a normal takt plan with trades 1, 2, and 3, and you say, hey, instead of two zones, I want 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is a really nice way to draw this. If you ever want to teach it, you just go ahead and draw half of that, right? And then half of that, and half of that, and half of that. And so what happens is that becomes your first trade, right? And you'll see that the end dates pretty much coincide. And then what happens is, as you start to scale this down and you take these three and you actually simulate it, you'll find out that the end date is much different. So the third thing you can have is the right number of zones, okay? So this is key in production scheduling, because you're not going to go any faster than your slowest trade. So I'll just go ahead and write this up here. Whatever your slowest trade is, that's the pace of your job, or your slowest zone, okay? That's the pace of your job, or the number of zones. If you don't have the right number, all three of those things can become the limiting factors in your schedule. So right now, going off of this video, you can do this analysis, you can do this analysis, and you can go actually simulate this, even if it was just in Excel. We have calculators for you that we'll link you to in the description below, but you can do this analysis already today. So what's beautiful about this is that if I do a good enough job in this video, hopefully you'll like and subscribe, and we'll keep getting this content. But really, in all seriousness, thank you for doing that. But in all seriousness, once you have a phase where your trades have been leveled, your zones have been leveled, and you have the right number of zones, right? You have this, and I always talk about it, this parallelogram, okay? And there's a couple things that this does, which is absolutely fantastic. Again, if you have bottlenecks, you'll always be able to see if there's a bottleneck inside the zone itself or in a trade. So you're always able to see that real time. But from a production principle standpoint, that's not the only thing. Meaning, yes, you want to be able to see your bottlenecks, okay, because that is a pace setter in your project. But number two, you will want to level work in process. And that means that if you, like, let's say that you had a normal CPM schedule, which is completely worthless, don't get mad at me, and you do a histogram and your work in process looks like this, if there's a lot of high variability. Well, if you expect your work in process to be over the actual capacity of the crews, all that's going to do is extend your overall total project duration, and it's really going to fail your project, which we'll explain in other videos on this channel. But if you level it, right, and you actually get the production done, you'll actually get the soonest overall target. So when you're in the takt production system, if I was going to do a histogram of this, it would look like this: workers coming on site, beautifully leveled, and then going away. So in a takt production system, you'll always level your work in process, which will keep you safe. The other thing with your takt plan is, not only do you know when to start, but you also know when you are to finish which means that you can punch and finish as you go and make sure that you're finishing the product real time in what's called one process flow. And the last thing that I want to say, I don't want to make the video too long, but this provides the framework for you to actually prepare the phase, which we also talk about in other videos on this channel. If you're not getting my message, this is a cool channel. Anyway, so you're able to prepare the work and also identify buffers in the system so that everything in here can be stable as you do your work. It's really, really quite genius. Now, the reason I told you the base components of all of these parts, meaning how to just go ahead and map out the trades, how to look at the zones and how to analyze the zones, is because there's a key point in here. This type of scheduling works with all different types of projects and commissioning and civil, and you can also use this to map out your design and your supply chains, the manufacturing portion of your project. The bottom line is that these basic tools are absolutely fantastic. And I really, really hope that you're able to avail yourselves of them on your project site. If you need any additional support, I'm gonna give you in the description below a link to our website, and you can get basically anything you need there. And if you don't see it real time, reach out to us in the contact form. At the end of the day, you can master productivity and production and construction. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.